Major League Baseball star Freddy Sanchez loves playing ball, and it's been that way for as long as he can remember. As a kid growing up in downtown Los Angeles, he spent many long summer days swinging for the fences at local parks.
Sports was my whole life, basically. I was just out there every day playing baseball, and you know, sports was the biggest thing for me.
Eventually, Freddie's childhood passion turned into his profession, and in 2006, he won the National League batting title, and a year later, made the National League All-Star team. But his success might never have happened without Children's Hospital Los Angeles. Freddie was born with a club foot that required surgery and months of challenging rehabilitation.
The Children's Hospital was a big part of my early life. You know, my mom used to take the bus 3 times a week to get me to the hospital to do my cast or to change whatever she had to do or just for checkups.
Now, every time he steps on the field, Freddy Sanchez gives silent thanks to the caregivers at Children's Hospital Los Angeles who made his career as an athlete possible.
Who knows where I would be today without it, you know, and the caring people and the nurses and doctors who helped me get through this. I never forget where I came from and what happened at an early age.
30 years later, the hospital still helps children all over the city live out their sporting dreams. And although relatively few will make it to the major leagues, the hospital's specialized sports medicine program, run by orthopedic surgeon Dr. Jennifer Weiss, treats a growing number of young patients who get injured in action.
In the last decade or so, this has been a subspecialty that's really risen in need. The kids in our society are playing a lot more sports, and there have been a number of us that have cropped up in terms of our specialization, taking care of kids with these sports injuries.
By the age of 10, Katie Stone from Bakersfield was already an avid athlete.
Katie started out with the t-ball and soccer, and as she got older, she continued with the soccer and started with volleyball as well.
Her parents always encouraged her, happy that their daughter liked to be active and stay fit.
We always wanted our kids to do sports, and Katie has always gravitated toward them. It never even crosses your mind that your child is going to get seriously injured in a sport.
Then, one night at soccer practice when Tiffany was coaching her daughter, everything changed for Katie Stone.
Katie just suddenly came to me with tears in her eyes and said, "Mom, I'm in so much pain, I just can't play." And I said, "Okay, you'll be okay. We're just gonna scrimmage, you know, suck it up, let's go." And she said, "Mom, I can't." I mean, just tears pouring down her face. She said, "I just can't." At that point, I knew that something definitely was wrong with Katie.
An MRI showed that Katie had a torn meniscus in her left knee. She needed surgery, either to repair or remove the small piece of cartilage. But her parents wanted a second opinion.
I wanted somebody who looked at little people's knees all the time. I wanted somebody who understood the mechanics of a knee that's still growing. That was very important to us.
So the family drove over 100 miles to Children's Hospital Los Angeles to see Dr. Jennifer Weiss, and they were glad they did.
One of the things that I loved the most about her from our very first visit is she looked at Katie and she spent so much time examining her. And she really listened to what Katie had to say.
I really like Dr. Weiss. She's really nice and she's comfortable to be around.
But both Katie and her mother were worried about undergoing such major surgery.
They were nervous about her losing her meniscus. What I counsel the family is there's really 3 things that might happen. Number one, we could go in and the MRI could be wrong. There might not be a tear. Number two, we might need to remove some meniscus. But number three, I prepare them that hopefully, if there's a tear, it's in an area that can be fixed.
Like most parents of prospective surgery patients, the Stones worried about the pain and the strong drugs Katie would need after surgery. But Dr. Weiss had a solution for that, too. A unique, targeted pain management technique developed by her colleague, Dr. Giovanni Cucciaro.
Usually after surgery, we give patients receive opioids, medications like Vicodin, and we all know that these medications have high incidence of side effects.
To reduce those side effects, Dr. Cucciaro has developed a way of giving these medicines directly to the affected area, rather than in pill form, which impacts the child's entire system. he inserts a small catheter near the site of the incision, which will deliver the pain medication after the surgery.
We hook up these catheters to devices that keep delivering preset amounts of local anesthetic, and so it blocks the nerve, and so there is no more pain transmission that reaches the central nervous system.
Reassured, the Stone family set the date for surgery. Despite knowing Katie was in the best hands possible, the moment when her little girl headed to the OR tore at Tiffany's heart.
When Katie went back for surgery, everything inside me twisted. It's just the thought of your baby being put under. It was definitely tough.
I remember just being scared and nervous, but also still kind of excited just to get it over with.
As Dr. Weiss prepared to operate, Dr. Cucciaro inserted the catheter that would provide the pain medication after the surgery. Once that was done, Dr. Weiss made tiny incisions and operated her surgical tools from outside the knee.
An arthroscopy, which is a surgery that is aided by a camera. What we're relying on is a camera inside the knee or whatever joint we're working on, and then another hole or two to put tools through.
By shining a light on the affected area inside the knee, Dr. Weiss could finally see what was causing the problem.
What I've just discovered here, I'll give me the probe again. This, you can see as I lift up here, you can see right through there. We're not supposed to be able to do that. That little triangle of darkness in the back there, that is her tear. So when I went in, she had a tear that was simple in nature. It was in an area that gets blood supply, and it was not huge. So I was able to fix it with stitches from the inside.
With the procedure almost complete, Katie's parents anxiously waited for news from the doctors.
I started crying. I just wanted Katie. I just wanted to see her, to know that she was okay. I just wanted to see her and hug her.
And finally, Dr. Weiss arrived with the good news.
Hey guys, you're coming here. I'll tell you about it. Everything went really well. Is he gonna get to come?
Yes.
We repaired and we released.
Katie was able to leave the hospital that same day, and thanks to the targeted pain medication, she experienced very little discomfort. Her recovery went smoother and faster than the family could have ever imagined.
It was really nice just to be able to go home and not have to stay the night in the hospital, because it was already scary enough as it was.
And within 2 months of the surgery, Katie was able to resume activity out on the sports field.
It was that quick. Within 3 months, she was running the mile in PE at school and back on the court playing volleyball.
And that was one of the happiest things in my life, just to finally be able to walk and run and go play sports again.
And that's exactly what Dr. Weiss hoped would happen. Because although she treats sports injuries for a living, the last thing the doctor wants is to discourage children from being active. Her message? Exercise often and vigorously, but at the same time, be careful.
We know that there's a big problem with childhood obesity in this country, and encouraging children to play sports and be active is very important in terms of controlling that health-wise.
I'm very grateful for Dr. Weiss for that surgery, and it's like amazing just to be able to like be back of how I was before the whole injury.